Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. May I also extend my welcome to colleagues, students, alumni, friends, and partners. It's great to see you all here, particularly in this, such a bad weather. Let me begin by asking a question. What is the University of Surrey best known for? Well, the question perhaps can also be asked, what's the University of Surrey's distinctive competitive advantage or unique selling points? Just hold your thought. I'll return to this question later. The numbers on the slides paint nicely the picture, a nice picture of the state of play of the University of Surrey. It is very pleasing to know that we make some £1.7 billion contribution to the national economy, and we have thriving relationships with more than 2,300 partners around the globe for our student placement and research collaborations. We continue to attract a talented, a wide range, a diverse range of staff and students from across the globe. Over 110,000 alumni in more than 140 countries are making a huge contribution to society, and they are, in my view, a great asset for the university, indeed for the Surrey community. We are very proud of them, and we are very proud of the fact that we keep producing more, ever more quality graduates for the world. 2017 has been a fantastic year for the university and our community, with many notable achievements. Let me just highlight a few. In May, we celebrated 50 years in Guildford with a delightful festival of wonder, attended by some 6,000 people across the whole county and beyond. They experienced firsthand our cutting-edge research with a lot of exciting talks, shows, and music. Everyone and every family I knew had a great day, a fun day on campus. In May, we also held a very successful graduation ceremony in China, in Beijing, as part of our golden anniversary celebrations. Our senior staff welcomed, met, interacted with more than 300 Surrey graduates and their families. And in June, our student staff celebrated our Gold Award in the first ever Teaching Excellence Award, Teaching Excellence Framework, recognizing the excellence of our teaching and exceptional student services, including the high student employability underpinned by our strong professional training year program. And you'll hear from one of the PTY students later on. And this is one of our many USPs that also led to the QS ranking in employability, placing us in the top 130 in the world in 2017. Another feather in Surrey's cap is the significant lifting of some 86 places to 362 in the world in the most prestigious academic ranking of world universities. In other words, it's a Shanghai ranking. But none of these are possible, achievable by the university alone. So therefore, I would like to express our sincere thanks, as Jim did, to our partners and supporters and friends, both here in Surrey and across the globe. A brilliant example of successful collaboration is our £18 million 5G Innovation Centre, which is partnered with more than 20 global companies and some SMEs here in the country. Together with the University of Bristol and King's College London, the centre received additional £16 million government funding to establish a new 5G hub as a national facility. And the researchers would use the facility to develop 5G technologies to underpin and enable innovations in digital health, transport, cybersecurity, and space, to name but a few. And in February, we completed our £12.5 million Innovation for Health building, which will help transform the healthcare in the country by providing interdisciplinary training and research across health sciences, medical sciences, and engineering. In June, we also launched a global center for clean air research to tackle local air pollution problems. Now, researchers are working with their colleagues from the University Global Partnership Network to develop solutions that will ensure clean air for all, both here and also in developing countries. In July, our sports park, the Surrey Sports Park, proudly hosted Women's Lacrosse World Cup, and a great opportunity to showcase the excellent facilities and also hospitality that we have collectively to offer in Guildford. And in October, we marked the 10th anniversary of the Surrey International Institute, which is a joint venture with the Dongbei University of Finance and Economics. Many of our young alumni from this institute have already become leaders in government and private enterprises in China and beyond. Another amazing achievement that you will hear more later on is our fourth Queen's Anniversary Prize for Higher and Further Education. And these awards recognize the excellence we have in both food and nutrition sciences. And this is indeed very exciting and very inspiring to all our students and staff alike. Again, thanks to our partners, to our supporters around the globe who have helped us to achieve such a great, wonderful accolade. Now, turning from the highlights of the past year to the goals for the future, our ambition is to be the global leading university renowned for the outstanding quality for our students and the graduates, and for the impact of our research. Together, we're making a greater contribution and positive change to the world. To achieve our ambition, we think we'd like to be, and we need to be, a global leader in higher education, a destination of choice for our students. We need to be a connected, engaged university with our alumni and with our communities, both locally and globally. And we need to be financially viable. We need to be financially astute, sustainable, adaptive institution. And we like to think we'll be a preferred partner for government, business, industry, and other institutions. And last but not least, we'll continue to improve, we'll continue to excel in the research and innovation activities we do, so that we'll be a global leading research institution. To achieve these goals, we already embarked on quite a few really ambitious and exciting new initiatives. For example, our new medical school will produce digital doctors for future connected and holistic healthcare, and drawing on our strength in the 5G, the likes of engineering sciences and innovation for health and many other disciplines, we will have a uniquely world-leading medical program. If everything goes well, we will open our doors to more than 100 students, we hope, in September 2019. So watch this space. Now, by working with partners, we are also planning to build a state-of-the-art learning hotel, which will offer practice-based research and training to further strengthen our already very highly ranked hospitality and tourism management program. In April, we'll be also hosting the academic leaders from our UGPN partners, namely University of São Paulo, the North Carolina State, and Wollongong. Already, the researchers from these institutions already initiated some 40 research projects across areas such as antimicrobial resistance, aging and nutrition, energy storage, air pollution, and climate change adaptation. At the University of Surrey, we are very proud to work with and also give back to our community, through whether it's through our research activities, volunteering, and other support to our local communities' activities in charity. For example, the Surrey Health Aging Research Partnerships focus on long-term conditions and healthy living in our communities. One of our past student union presidents, Emily Boland, who won the Eagle Radio Local Heroes Award for Music and the Arts last year, will help people with autism through her charity single she recorded with the Motivation by Music Gospel Choir. And our technology integrated health management system that was led by researchers from the 5G Innovation Center, working with Surrey and Borders, has been rolled out to more than 100 dementia patients' homes, providing them with better and connected care with smart Internet of Things technology and expert advice. And this project won last year the Best Mental Health Initiative Award. In addition, of course, we are working with many charities. We're supporting many of our local charities, just to name a few. Transform and Surrey Youth Focus, Surrey Hills Society, a community foundation for Surrey, King's College Guildford, and of course, our iconic Guildford Innovation Festival. And these are the initiatives and the activities that are actually centered around our community's needs and the future for our community and society. I asked at the beginning the question, what is the University of Surrey best known for? So I have touched on some of the university's advantages, uniqueness, in our offerings from students to research, but ultimately our ambition is to inspire people to make a positive change, to make an impact. We are truly a global community of ideas and people dedicated to world-changing, life-changing education and research. And we do provide, on our beautiful campus here, exceptional teaching to inspire and empower our students for personal and professional success. And we do world-class research that will have transformational impact on our society, not the least help shaping the future digital economy, which is a great strength that we have. We succeed through agile and dynamic collaborations and partnerships with businesses and government and communities. So of course we want to do more. We want to make even greater contribution to society in the future, and we can do it through your help, be it through goodwill, your time, and philanthropic support. And this, in essence, is the Surrey ambition. Surrey inspires us all to work together to shape a better world tomorrow. So I look forward to working with you all. Thank you very much.